The drug's trials specialist, Ergomed, has told investors they've received positive top-line results from a phase 2 clinical trial of a treatment for insomnia with its co-development partner, Ferrer. With me on the line now to discuss in much more detail is Chief Business Officer, Andrew Mackie. Andrew, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Andrew, first off, tell me a little bit more about the results here. I know you had both 5 and 10 milligram doses of the drug. Is that correct?
That's right. So the trial was designed in a crossover manner, which means that every patient receives in sequential manner each dose of the study treatment. So in this case, that meant they received two doses of Lorediplon, one dose of Zolpidem, and placebo. And the statisticians come up with random orders of how the patients receive the drugs, and then that helps you analyze the data because it means that each patient in essence, access their own control. So you can pool the data across all the patients, but you can also look for the effects in individual patients.
Andrew, what have you learned about the safety profile for Lorediplon?
Well, importantly for this class of drugs, what we've seen so far are two important things. So whilst the patients are on the drug, it seems to have a very similar safety profile to the existing medications. But importantly, at our first look at the data so far, so as you can imagine, on Friday night, we received the statistical report, which is 600-some pages long. So there's a lot of data in there that we need to look at more carefully. But our initial look indicates that the safety profile is very similar to Zolpidem, so consistent with a class of drugs. But also, these drugs can affect people's alertness early in the morning. So they take the pill when they go to sleep, and it has a little bit of what they call a hangover effect. And what we've seen so far in the data is that Lorediplon doesn't seem to have a hangover effect, so patients wake up refreshed. So the idea of why Ferrer started in this development is most sleeping tablets on the market at the moment, you take them as you go to bed, and they have a tendency to last for the first half of the night. So they keep you asleep, but many, many patients have mid and late or second half period awakenings. What Ferrer did is they played around with the chemistry of some of the drugs on the market, discovered a new molecule that has a prolonged duration effect. So whilst it helps you sleep in the first half of the night, it actually maintains your sleep in the second half of the night. And what we've seen in this data is not only is the drug effective against placebo, which we have to prove because that's the regulatory path, we've also seen some good signals that it's effective and better than some of the market leaders in maintaining the sleep in the second half of the night. But as I say, initial data and the study was set up to look at the effect against placebo. So the effect against Zolpidem is trending in the right direction. It's indicative. We've got some very good results in that second half of the period. But we need to look at these more carefully.
Insomnia is a condition I'd imagine most people have heard of, but have you got any numbers on just what the actual potential commercial market here is for the drug?
Yeah, well, the whole market size is a couple of billion dollars, it's a market that's not really growing at the moment. So whilst the incidence of insomnia is high and on the rise, you know, a lot of us are suffering from it. Because a lot of the drugs currently on the market are going off patent and becoming generic, the commercial size of the market is tending to stay about the same size or falling slightly by a percent or two year on year. So it's a big market, but there is some competition in there. However, what our analysts are saying and what we believe is Lorediplon has a distinction against the products on the market in this ability to keep people asleep throughout the night and having an ability to wake up without any of the hangover effects. So if this profile turns out to be confirmed in later trials, we think this product is well positioned to capture a significant portion of that market.
One thing I wanted to get a comment from you on, Andrew, was I saw a remark that Ergomed made suggesting that these results endorse the company's co-development business model. Can you just explain a little bit more about how that's so?
Absolutely. So what we've tried to do is build our company in two ways. So we have a classic service offering on one side of the company where we supply services to the pharmaceutical and biotech industry to help them develop their drugs. And this generates about 38 million pounds worth of revenue And we haven't announced our profit line, but last year we announced profits of around £3 million. So this generates a very solid, stable part of the company. What we also try and do is gain some exposure to product development or the commercial success of individual products. So we're using the expertise that the company has built up over the last 20 years, running trials, and applying it to, in essence, our own drug research. So we do that in two ways. We have a couple of products that Ergomed own that we're developing ourselves in the surgical bleeding space. So we are developing these like any other biotech company. But we also have what we call our shared risk partnership. And this is the Ferrer relationship is an example of that. So what we do there is we offer to run the clinical trials with our partners at a discount. And for the discount, we gain some upside in the product's future. So in this case, what we did is we ran the Ferrer study for them, as I said, at a reduced cost. And we will get a percentage from any revenues which Ferrer make from the commercialization of the product. So if they decide to partner the product at this stage and they get an upfront milestone in that partnering process, we would get a share of that. Ultimately, when they're making sales themselves or getting royalties from their partners, we will get a share of those sales and royalties.
Just a final word, Andrew, if you would. Just run us through what other studies you've got underway at the moment and where you're at with those.
Yeah, okay. Well, just to highlight, so we have six partnerships in the moment across five drugs. These range from mid-sized pharma companies like Ferrer to classic biotech companies. So we have a couple of relationships with spin-outs from the Karolinska Institute in Sweden. So these are all being developed in, they're different products being developed in different indications. But I suppose one to point out is that our partner, Eterna Centaurus, that are running an endometrial cancer program, and we've run their phase 3 pivotal study for them. They announced about 10 days ago that they've hit the end of the study. So basically, the outcome of 384 events has been reached. So we're now officially closing the study, collecting the last little bits of data, cleaning up the data, and we'll be analyzing that and announcing the results in the next couple of months.
Well, a busy time ahead for you, Andrew. I wish you all the best. Thanks very much indeed.
Thank you very much. All the best to you.